We're in the season of Pentecost. It's that time of year when the church remembers the way the Holy Spirit moved into the life of that early Christian community. Acts says it was as if there was a fierce, mighty wind, and there were flames of fire all around the room. It's a powerful image. And we've seen the images of fire all too clearly, all too frighteningly in recent days. We've seen the damage that fire has done in Minneapolis and Atlanta and other cities across the nation. We know how powerful that kind of fire can be. T.S. Eliot wrote a poem about the dove descending in fire, in which he said, "The only hope, or else despair, lies in the choice of pyre or pyre, to be redeemed from fire by fire. We only live, only suspire, consumed by either fire or fire." Which puts the challenging question before us: what kind of fire will burn? What kind of flame will consume our lives? Will we be consumed by the fires of systemic racism, of economic injustice, of white supremacy, of political corporate corruption, of repressed resentment and grievous anger, violence, even just plain old meanness? Or will we be consumed by the fire of divine love? Will we, like those early apostles, be filled, consumed, controlled by the fiery power of the love of God revealed in Christ? Paul described that active love, the kind of love that isn't just an emotion or a feeling. It's a way in which we live. It's the means by which we express the love of Christ. It's active love. In that beautiful 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians, here's Eugene Peterson's paraphrase of it. Love never gives up. Love cares more for others than for self. Love doesn't want what it doesn't have. Love doesn't strut, doesn't have a swelled head, doesn't force itself on others, isn't always me first, doesn't fly off the handle, doesn't keep score of the sins of others, doesn't revel when others grovel, takes pleasure in the flowering of truth, puts up with anything, trusts God always, always looks for the best, never looks back, but keeps going on to the end. So, which fire will it be? In your life, in mine, in our life, as a nation? Eliot would say, we only live, only suspire. That's an early English word that means breathe. We only live, only suspire, consumed by fire or fire. In these difficult and fiery days, may we discover the love of God in Christ alive within us, directing our actions and our attitudes until we are consumed by the fiery love of God. Thanks be to God.